They better get their hands off of Syria. Yeah. You better get your hands off of Syria. Don't believe all the media hysteria. They say the whole country is against Assad. What about every single pro-government march? What about the character of the opposition? What kind of government do they really envision? It's like Libya 2.0 if you ask me. The CIA is now just sitting and laughing. They take popular discontent and spin it. Want to see the Arab revolution diminished. What about Palestine support from Damascus? Will that still remain if the country is captured? Clear that the Zionists support the rebels. They want to see the Baathist state just leveled. Who really benefits is the question to ask. We should know much better from the most recent past. The balance of forces in the world today. Know the biggest enemy is the USA. Know they scheme and manipulate each step of the way. But they not messing with Syria today. They better get their hands off of Syria. 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 Syria. We need to put things in historical context. Otherwise, all we talking is nonsense. First of all, what's democracy? Does it take precedence over sovereignty? There's been problems in Syria for quite a long time. Yes, they are very real, and yes, you'll find some very real, genuine discontent. But it's not the overwhelming environment. And these very real shortcomings of the state don't make it like Egypt, a client state. Want to knock Syria en route to Iran and sever the anti-imperial bond. People die in war, an unfortunate fact. It's not a one-sided string of attacks. Rebels killing Christians, Alawis, and NATO's on the ground, there's no need to pretend. The balance of forces in the world today. Know the biggest enemy is the USA. Know they scheme and manipulate each step of the way. But they not messing with Syria today. Say they better get their hands off of Syria. They better get their hands off of Syria. They better get their hands off of Syria. You better get your hands off of Syria.